Well, it's Easter Sunday, and here I am at my church. Now, as you can see from the footage I shot before sitting down, the parking lot is empty. There are no children running around as there normally would be. There's no parish-wide Easter egg hunt, any of those things, because 2020 has turned out to be an extraordinary year in many ways. We have had our Easter services online, and at least that gives us the opportunity to see our friends, which was great. So far as I know, no one in our congregation has been afflicted with the COVID-19. And we're like all our friends, I think, we're hunkered down at home, binge watching far more television than we should, hopefully reading more books than we give ourselves the chance to. But what are we supposed to make of this new situation? I hesitate to call it the new normal because that's not what I hope it is. Dr. Anthony Fauci, who has been giving out accurate information about the coronavirus and the pandemic associated with it, has said that we afterwards may never be able to shake hands again. I hope that's not the case, because shaking hands is a gesture of Western civilization that has existed for hundreds and hundreds of years. Its origins lie in part from showing that your right hand does not have a weapon in it. And it's since the time when people pretty much stopped carrying around edged weapons, swords or daggers, it's become more of a social greeting. And I hope we won't have lost that. So it was great to see my friends from church online, to see all their faces, because it's been several weeks now since we've been able to do that. And it looks like they're all managing pretty well, but we really do miss having the opportunity to see each other face to face, not just to shake hands, but also to hug. In my Christian tradition, we do something called passing the peace. And that's when a part of the time in the service where everybody in the congregation has the opportunity to get up, move around, greet their friends, meet the people they don't know who may be visiting, and so on. And it's a really important part of what goes on in our church. Maybe it does in the place where you worship too. So I haven't come to any conclusions about what's going to happen or how things might change given this new situation, not just in American society, but in the world. But I'd be interested in knowing in the comments what you've been going through and how you're doing. So take a minute after this video to add to the comments in this episode of Certainly Curated Eccentricities. Perhaps that name for my video series is more appropriate than it's ever been before. Be well, be safe, and thank you.